الحمد لله، الحمد لله الكريم الوهاب الرحيم التواب غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم، ولا خمسة إلا هو سادسهم، ولا أدنى من ذلك ولا أكثر إلا هو معهم أينما كانوا، ثم ينبئهم بما عملوا يوم القيامة. إن الله بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه، أشهد يا رسول الله أنك قد بلغت الرسالة وأديت الأمانة ونصحت الأمة وكشف الله سبحانه وتعالى بك الغمة وتركتنا على المحاجة البيضاء ليلها واضح كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك ولا يتنكبها إلا خاسر. ثم أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الأحباب، أسأل الله العلي الكبير في هذا اليوم المبارك وفي هذا المسجد المبارك أن يغفر لي ولكم الذنوب، وأن يسر عنا العيوب، وأن يحشرني وإياكم والمسلمين في مستقر رحمته تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. اللهم آمين آمين يا أرحم الراحمين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God, as He should be feared. I testify that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when we talk about that man, he used to live during the time of Prophet Dawood or David. He was not a famous man, just normal person, even under normal person. He was a slave, a slave. Some scholars, they said he used to live in Aswan in Egypt, or he used to live in Abyssinia or Sudan, wherever he used to live in Africa around that area. That man, who was a slave working for his master, very tall man, skinny, black skin, big lips, big nose, big ears, small head. Who's that man? That man, he was not a Nabi, but we have chapter in the Holy Quran under his name. We have surah, we call that Surah Luqman, or the wise Luqman, Luqman al-Hakim. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored that man? That man, he came during the time of Sayyidina Dawood, and in the end of the time of Sayyidina Dawood, and he learned from Sayyidina Dawood a lot. Prophet Dawood, he learned from him a lot. Luqman al-Hakim, he was not a Nabi, just normal person. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed him and gifted him with what? With wisdom. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنُشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. We did give Luqman al-Hikmah, we granted him al-Hikmah, wisdom. وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ إِلَّا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. فالله gave الحكمة, wisdom to somebody, he gave him all kind of خيرات, all kind of good. وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنُشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. فالله gave you something, brothers and sisters, be grateful to Allah, be thankful to Allah, thank you Allah. Don't fight Allah, don't be against Allah with that tools or that money or that position or that thing he gave it to you. No, be grateful to him. Humble yourself. say alhamdulillah, shukri lillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take it from somebody, give it to me. He gave you children, somebody has no children. He gave you money, somebody has no money. He gave you a good house, somebody has no house. He gave you a position, education, he gave you too many things. He gave you health, somebody laying in the hospitals. Say alhamdulillah. You have to be grateful to Allah. Don't deny his ni'mah. Anushkur lillah. And if you be grateful to Allah, وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ, actually Allah doesn't need your shukr. Even he doesn't need your ibadah. وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ لِنَفْسِهِ. This is for yourself. You're doing that for yourself. Brothers, Sayyidina Luqman, our master Luqman, he gave us 10 advices in Surah, in the Quran mentioned that in his chapter, to his son, to his dear son. That's why he used the word Ya Bunay. All of us will love our children without any doubt. That's why Luqman alayhi al-Hakim, he used to say Ya Bunay, when he used to advise his son. We have to advise our children. Our children, they need, they are in need to our advices. Whatever you can say, say. Maw'idha, nasiha, khutbah. Whatever you can say, say. But let's say nasiha, advice. We have every while, we have to advise our kids. Especially in this society. And I'm just trying to remind you how Luqman advised his son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in the Holy Quran. Let's make it short because the time. First of all, he said, وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ وَهُوَ يَعِظُهُ يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. While he was advising, actually maw'idha different from nasiha. And Allah mentioned the word, وَهُوَ يَعِظُهُ. Maw'idha in Arabic different from nasiha. Nasiha can give nasiha about حتى the will, اللي هي التوصية different from nasiha, different from maw'idha. You know, the will, something you give khair to somebody before you die, your inheritance or whatever. Nasiha to advise people, do this and don't do that in a nice way, in a wise way. But al-maw'idha, like khutbah al-jum'ah, al-maw'idha means very strong and very short words and remind you, targhib wa tarhib, remind you about al-akhirah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he advised his son, Luqman, he advised his son and he said, وَهُوَ يَعِظُهُ, he gave him maw'idha. Ya Bunay, oh my dear son, don't ascribe partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in too many ways. When you slaughter, when you pray, when you fast, when you make hajj, everything, all of your ibadah, your life, your death, all belongs to Allah, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Brothers, Allah the one who gave you this life. Allah the one who make you breathe. Allah the one who guide you to come to pray Salat al-Jum'ah today. He gave you that iman in your heart. Be grateful to Allah. Everything in our life belongs to Allah. And all of us, we will return back to Him. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. We have to get certainty, yaqeen, وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. We will be back to Allah. That's why Luqman, he said, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. It's a great transgression if you make shirk. And the worshipping Allah alone, they call it Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, the oneness of Allah, part of Tawheed. Tawheed al-Uluhiyya, wal-Rububiyya, wal-Asma' al-Safat, part of Tawheed. In our creed, aqeedah, to worship Allah alone. And this is the core of the message of Islam. How? All the Anbiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they came with the same message. Ya qawm i'budu Allah ma lakum min ilahin ghayru. All the Anbiya of Allah. Oh my own people, worship Allah. There is no God but He. He's your God. He's your ilah. And subhanallah, for example, I'll give you an example right now. In Surah Taha, in the beginning of the Surah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the prophethood, a nubuwa to Musa alayhi salam, what did he say? وَأَنَا اخْتَرْتُكَ فَاسْتَمِعْ لِمَا يُوحَى. I chosen you, listen to what I'm gonna reveal to you. Allah is telling Musa now, huh? إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهِ فَاعْبُدْنِي. فَاعْبُدْنِي, huh? Tawheed. Then, وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. then he reminded him about the akhirah. إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى فلا يصدنك عنها من لا يؤمن بها واتبع هواه فتردى. That's it. This is advice. خلاص. Now you're gonna be a prophet. If you get that certainty, يقين of that I'm your God, I'm the only God to you, يا موسى. Allah said that he is the good only God. إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا. There is no God but He. Allah عز وجل. He talked to Musa. فاعبدني. What you have to do? فاعبدني. Worship me alone. That's it. This is the core of Islam. All the message of Islam from Adam to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to قيام الساعة. Worship Allah alone. وأقم الصلاة لذكري. Second, after شهادتان, five pillars, شهادتان, then الركن الأول من الناحية العملية الصلاة. Because you say شهادة with your tongue and you believe it with your heart. That's it. You're not working. But the first rukn actually in Islam, first pillar in Islam, as-salah, from the action way. Because when you make salah, now you're working, you're bowing, you're prostrating, you're making wudu, you're moving. وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. Establish the salah, the prayer, the namaz, for my remembrance. And he reminded him by al-akhirah. Luqman, let's go back to Luqman. Second advice, first advice, he said, this is your relationship with Allah. Worship Allah alone, don't sit any, ascribe any partner to Allah, partners to Allah. Second, he said, your relationship with your parents, very important. Brother, come forward, inshallah, because your brother is standing in the back and there are too many spots. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ تَفَسَّحُوا فِي الْمَجَالِسِ فَفْسَحُوا يَفْسَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ. Come close, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. Give room to your brothers, inshallah. Second advice, he said, وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ. حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to respect and to treat our parents good, especially your mother. Because she, despite weakness upon weakness when she was carrying you in her womb. وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَمَيْنِ. This is second advice. Your relationship with your parents. Be grateful and respect your parents. Also, he reminded him when his son, I read that, Al-Imam Al-Bujayli, or I'm sorry, Al-Ujayli, Imam Al-Ujayli, he mentioned that and he said, while Luqman was advising his son asked him, my dad, if I make any sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching me. He knows what I'm doing. And Allah mentioned that ayah. When Luqman advised him and he gave him the meaning of this ayah, which is going to recite it right now, Imam Al-Ujayli said, the son of Luqman, he died after that. He couldn't carry it. The man died. The boy died. Subhanallah. He said, يَا بُنَيْ إِنَّهَا إِنْ تَكُمْ إِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلْ فَتَكُمْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهِ. ليه؟ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ. Because Allah لطيف خبير. The meaning, he said, my dear son, in fact, if there be anything to the measure of a grain of ray or mustard seed, and it be hidden in a rock or in the heavens or in the earth, Allah will bring it forth. And his son died after that. He cannot carry it. Because he knows, if Allah knows this, what about us? If we make sin and we disobey him, do you think he's not full worship? He's not watching you? He doesn't know what you're doing? After that, he gave him some adab for his personal, how to deal with yourself. Dealing with Allah, dealing with your parents. And you have to know Allah's watching. Then he gave him some advices to himself for his identity person, as a person. How to deal with yourself. To be a good Muslim, to have a good identity as a Muslim, good manners and good akhlaq. Said, Ya Bunayya, again, salah. Aqim salata. Establish salah. Wa'amur bil ma'roof. Wa'amur bil ma'roof. Wanha anil munkar. And he said, Umur bil ma'roof and bid the fair and forbid the unfair. Join people for ma'roof. وَنْهَا عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. Look to this ayah, I like to read it like this way, because I know the tafsir. said, يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف. Easy, establish salah. Brother, let's go to the masjid. جزاك الله خير يا شيخ. And join people for معروف. جزاك الله خير يا شيخ. That's beautiful. Huh? I'm gonna start right now. وانهى عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك. When you forbid the منكر now, you have to be patient. Why? Because maybe somebody gonna hurt you and harm you. Forbidding the munkar is not easy. وانهى عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك. إن ذلك من عزم الأمور. Forbidding the munkar is not easy. And you have to have some kind of rules when you forbid the munkar too, because you can hurt yourself. You have to be patient. That's why he said, Subhanallah. He said, be patient and observe patience on what befalls you, because something can happen to you if you forbid people from the munkar. And then he said, وَلَا تُصَعِرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. About you as a my son, how to deal with yourself. He said, don't turn your face or cheek away from people. Don't be proud. Don't be arrogant. وَقْصِدْ فِي مَشْيِكَ. أقصد في مشيك. We need this, all of us. Do you know if certain people nowadays they understand this ayah, وقصد, قصد, be moderate. We'll never see somebody called ISIS or somebody's killing Muslim around the world nowadays. We'll never see these people which they are saying the society kuffar and they are killing people. This is misunderstanding of Islam. Like somebody carrying a book not in the right way, upside down, and he's reading. He knows the information, but he get it wrong. He observed it, and he get it in his mind wrong. Did Islam tell you, go kill people? No. Islam is not like this. We learn a different Islam. This is not the Islam. No. Because if the Kaaba will be destroyed, if the Kaaba, our direction, our Kaaba, be destroyed, it's easier in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from killing and shedding blood any Muslim. Don't shed his blood. Destroy Kaaba, no problem in the sight of Allah. But don't shed the blood of Muslim. We have to understand our deen. Understanding Islam, imagine this book like this. I have to read it like this, but I make it like this, upside down, and I'm reading. This is the one who misunderstands Islam. He read it in the wrong way. He understood the meaning of what Allah said, his commands, and the sunnah of Rasulullah in the wrong way. He misunderstand. That's why Islam is beautiful, but we are bad. We are bad. Subhanallah, if your son get sick, Allah forbid, will go. You're gonna see the best doctor in the society. Even if he's not in your country, you're gonna travel for that doctor. But when you come to the Islam, just take it from anybody. It's okay. It's not okay. Imam Malik, he said, "In هذا العلم دين." This knowledge is deen. فانظروا عمن تأخذون دينكم. You have to watch from who you're going to take your deen. Not anybody. He have a turbaner, he have like long beard, and they said, I'm sheikh, take your deen from him. No. You have to go to the people of knowledge. سألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. Ask the people of ذكر if you don't know. Not anybody. This knowledge is deen. This is your deen. If you take wrong information, and you apply it, you act, you follow it, you're following different deen then. We need to follow the deen of Allah. The beauty of Islam. Peace, love, forgiveness. Does not mean I have to be weak. No. This has nothing to do with weakness. No. But the asli of Islam, samaha, love, forgiveness, peace. Give peace to the community. Give peace to your family. Give peace to your children. Your neighbors, this is Islam, brothers. This is the beauty of Islam. Very important to understand this. And this is some advices of Luqman to his son. And he said, وَقْصِدْ فِي مَشْيِكَ. Be moderate when you walk. وَغْضُدْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ. He said, lower your voice. Because the harshest voices in the sight of Allah, the voice of or braying of the ass or the donkey. That's why moderation is very important. He said, be moderate, waqsud, not just when you walk, when you eat, when you talk, when you walk, when you sleep. القصد وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا. You are أمة وسط in everything, no extreme. Because you know that three types of people they came to Rasulullah, one of them said, Ya Rasulullah, I will never marry women. And you see, the العبادة المنحرفة, I don't like it. عبادة المنحرفة, I will never marry women. Another one said, Ya Rasulullah, I will never sleep at night. He thinks he's doing something good. The third one said, Ya Rasulullah, I will fast every day. And Rasulullah, he stood up, well, he was very mad. He said, no, this is not my deen. No, this is not my deen. I marry women. I pray and I sleep, and I'm not fasting, I'm fasting day by day if you want, you know. This is the way. We are human beings, we are weak. Imagine yourself, you're away like nuns from men or women like this. You will be away. The ibadah munharifa. You think you're gonna be okay? No. One day that natural desire Allah put at you as a man or a lady gonna scream, gonna yell to you. Gonna shout to you, what are you doing? Allah created me with this desire. You know, desire is not bad. It's bad if you are not controlling this desire and put it in the right way. But Allah created us with it. Put it in the halal way. It's okay. Control that desire, but it's not bad. That's good. Like if somebody's telling me, Ya Sheikh, I am a very good person. I never look to the women. I said, maybe I'm in doubt about you. Maybe you're not a real man. Because if you are a real man, you have to look to the woman. I'm not telling you go look to the woman. You have to control your desire. You know, if somebody's not looking to the woman or he's not desiring women, there's something wrong with him. Yeah, he should go to the doctor. You know, this to be honest with you. But that's why that desire, you have to put it in the right way. When you marry, you have a wife, you have like that. And somebody's telling me anger is bad. No, anger is not bad. الإمام الشافعي said من استغضب ولم يغضب فهو حمار. If somebody makes you mad and you will not be a mad, it's a donkey, you know. But the point here is to control your anger. لا تغضب لا تغضب لا. To control it. To being angry. Sometimes you have to be angry. Sometimes you have to react. But you have to control. You have to control. This is very important. Some advices also of Luqman, I have too many really. I get it from not just that ones in the Quran, I get it from the book of Al-Bidaya wa Nihaya, Ibn Kathir. For example, he said, oh my son, the one I will say it very fast because of time, you have to eat and feed just the atqiya, the good mu'mineen, the one who's coming to your house, the one who has taqwa Allah. And also, oh my son, share, make consultation with the ulama about your affairs. Don't go ask anybody for advice like that. Sit with the ulama and ask them. He said, oh my son, if you want to take somebody, brother in Islam or company to you, you have to make a test for him first. What I have to do? He said, make him mad first and see how he's going to react with you. If he deal with you justly, take him as a friend or a brother. If he will not be unjust with you, when you make him mad, just leave him alone. This is some of the advices of Luqman to his son. And he said, oh my son, لتكن كلمتك طيبة ووجهك بسطا. When you say something good or is better. From where Quran said that. وقولوا للناس حسنا. وقل لعبادي يقولوا سورة الإسراء. وقل لعبادي يقولوا التي هي أحسن أفعل التفضيل. The best word, the best of what you have. Say it. If you're not saying something good, it's better to stop your evil and don't say anything bad. And smile. ليكن وجهك بسطا. You know. And when Aisha radiallahu anha described Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa she said, كَانَ ضَحَّاكَ الْبَسَّامَ. He used to smile mostly sallallahu alayhi wa. If somebody making something haram against Allah, you see his face change. But mostly sallallahu alayhi wa, if you look to his face, smiling, big smile in his face sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nowadays, subhanAllah, you see brothers, mashallah, with his friends outside, mashallah, smiling, laughing, talking, joking. When he go to the house, he put 1,011 here, like Abu Jahl. He make himself a line, strong person. And when he came to the masjid too, brother, what's wrong with you? You was good outside. When you come to the masjid, why you turn your face like that? Smile, ya akhi. It's some kind of charity, sadaqah. Rasulullah said that. Ibtisamatuka fi wajhi akhika sadaqah. Smile, ya akhi. Give a smile. Draw that smile in your face. You're going to get sadaqah, charity. You know? You're going to give sadaqah or charity. You will be rewarded when you smile. Give that smile. Why you give that bad impression about Muslims? Subhanallah. ليكن وجهك بسطا. البسط يعني كلمة كبيرة قوي, يعني expanded as much as you can. سبحان الله. And he said, اتخذ طاعة الله تجارة يأتيك الرزق أو الأرباح بدون بضاعة. When you deal with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you make good deeds with Allah سبحانه وتعالى, you're making, ما شاء الله, you're earning a lot of profit without investment, without any merchandise, without anything, just you're getting your حسنات, a lot of حسنات. When you make business, subhanAllah, you have to invest some money to get that profit, right? When you deal with Allah, no, it's different. Just to come, do your service, you get that حسنات, mashallah, without anything. And he said, إياك, be aware, oh my son, oh my dear son, إياك وشدة الغضب, فإن شدة الغضب ممحقة لفؤاد الحكيم. Be aware from being very, very upset and mad, because that's going to wipe out your wisdom from your mind. If you became mad, that's why, subhanAllah, somebody became mad, he divorced his wife. He killed somebody. He said, oh, brother, I don't know what I'm doing. I did not know, you know, I am mad. I wasn't. قالت, subhanAllah, لا طلاق في إغلاق. يعني, subhanAllah, يعني, he's been blocked completely. That's why الغضبان كالسكران. Somebody became mad, he's like somebody drunk. سكران, you know. الغضبان كالسكران. He doesn't know what he's doing. That's why رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, when a man came to him, he said, يا رسول الله, advise me. He said, لا تغضب, don't be mad. Again, يا رسول الله, advise me. He said, لا تغضب, don't be mad. The third time he said, يا رسول الله, your advice. He said, لا تغضب ولك الجنة. Don't be mad and you will be in Jannah, inshallah. That's why very important to have to control yourself, brothers, inshallah. There are too many things in our life, يعني up and down, makes you mad, makes you kada, but subhanAllah, control. When you drive your car, if you don't have full control in your car, you're going to make accident. You have to make control in yourself. Very important. He said, oh my son, عليك بمجالسة العلماء واستمع إلى الحكماء. As much as you can, come to the masjid, sit with the scholars, ask the scholars in the phone, talk to the scholars about your affairs, about your issue, your life. Take advice from them and listen to the wise people as much as you can. This is going to benefit you in your life, give you some kind of benefit. And he said, عود لسانك أن يقول اللهم اغفر لي فإن لله ساعات لا ترد. Use your tongue saying, اللهم اغفر لي. Oh Allah, forgive my sin. أستغفر الله وأتوب إليه. I'm asking Allah forgiveness and I'm repenting to Him. اللهم اغفر لي. Because there are too many hours. It may be the gates of the heaven will be open and Allah will accept and receive your dua, your istighfar. Instead of insulting somebody, saying FSH words, whatever the people say, call it now. No, say اللهم اغفر لي. أستغفر الله. سبحان الله. الحمد لله. لا إله إلا الله. Say these duas. That will be good for you, inshallah, رب العالمين. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه يغفر لكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي المؤمنين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Just remind you brothers, inshallah, take care of your family and your kids. Always advise your kids in very nice way. لعبه سبعا, first 7 years play with your kid, second 7 years أدبه سبعا, train him, advise him, educate him, instruct him, you know, your kid. And then when we became 14, the last 7 years صاحبه سبعا, be a friend to him. I think if you're training somebody for 7 years, he will listen to you. Yeah. Educate your kids, brothers, like سيدنا لقمان أو لقمان. He used to say, Ya Bunayya, the word Ya Bunayya, oh my dear son, in very nice way, be gentle and kind and rahim to your kids. Even with your parents, like Sayyidina Ibrahim with his father, Ya Abati, Surat Maryam. He used to tell him, Ya Abati, oh my dear father. Well, he was a kafir. He did not get the and killing him, like what you see nowadays. Allah, subhanAllah. Especially brothers, I want you to educate your kids about Islam, because our kids nowadays, they are opening this YouTube and they see this things in Iraq and Syria and killing everywhere. Muslim and Muslim Ummah, they are not Muslim, they are Muslims. And Muslim killing Muslim. And if your kids, teenager or 15 or 17, is looking to this, he said, is that Islam? No. He cannot tell you no, but he's tongue, but inside, he's not accepting this. Don't blitter your kids. Don't think your kids doesn't understand, they are dumb. No, they understand more than me and you. Wallahi al-Azim. Deal with your kids in the right way. Sit with them. Be very close friend to them. Be open to them. Advise them like Luqman al-Hakim when he was advising his son. Learn from that. This is my point today. Learn from him. A last point, inshallah, because no time and the brother is standing. Some brothers always, subhanallah, I know they try to take the rukhsah for combining the salah during the rain time or something like that. Brothers, this is not zari'a, or if you don't have valid excuse for that, don't do it. Nowadays, mashallah, our house is very close. We have cars. We come to the masjid, carpet, mashallah, everything. You have the heater and the cold in the car, everything. And just when you see a little bit rain like this, your brother needs to combine the salah. This is not right. We need to have valid excuse, like if you have flood, if you have like snow, you cannot drive the car in the way, or something like that. Valid excuse for jam'ah and the qasr, you know, or for jam'ah salam, sorry, for jam'ah from the rain, you know. Don't just bother the imam, or don't tell him all the time we need jam'ah, jam'ah, jam'ah. No, this is not valid excuse. No, this is why you don't want to come to the masjid. It's up to you, you know. But don't force somebody. The imam of the masjid, he knows better than me and you about this. You know, he knows the fiqh and he knows the rules of al-jam' during the rain time, inshallah. جزاكم الله خير. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of you. Ameen ya rabbil alameen. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana, kaffir anna sayyatina, tawaffana ma'al abrar. اللهم عافنا في أسماعنا وأبصارنا وأبداننا يا أرحم الراحمين. انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين. أعلي بفضلك كلمتي الحق والدين. ردنا يا ربنا إلى ديننا ردا جميلا يا أرحم الراحمين. اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. إنك يا ربي سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين ويا رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى، ينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي، يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم أذكركم. أقم الصلاة، إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استقيموا، تراصوا، اعتدلوا. Straight the line, fill the gaps.
الله أكبر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. وإذ قال لقمان لابنه وهو يعظه: يا بني لا تشرك بالله، إن الشرك لظلم عظيم. ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه: حملته أمه وهنا على وهن، وفصاله في عامين، أن اشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير. وإن جاهداك على أن تشرك بي ما ليس لك به علم فلا تطعهما، وصاحبهما في الدنيا معروفا، واتبع سبيل من أناب إلي، ثم إلي مرجعكم فأنبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا بني إنها إن تك مثقال حبة من خردل فتكن في صخرة أو في السماوات أو في الأرض يأتي بها الله إن الله لطيف خبير. يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف وانه عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك إن ذلك من عزم الأمور. ولا تصعر خدك للناس ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور. وقصد في مشيك واغضض من صوتك إن أنكر الأصوات لصوت الحمير. الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
جزاكم الله خير برادرز. مي الله سبحانه وتعالى accept. امين يا رب العالمين. Please ان شاء الله don't forget to donate your message ان شاء الله.